What's up, blues fans? This is Anthony from Texas Blues Alley. Today, we have another Free Lesson Friday. This time, we're going to put your forearms and your wrist and even your elbows to work. And we are going to be playing some chords over the song Cry by Doyle Bramhall II. The reason I'm making this lesson is because a few weeks ago on Instagram, and if you're not following me there, you should. It's at Texas Blues Alley because I post the most ferocious blues guitar memes the world has ever seen. And occasionally I post little clips trying different things out. And about 2 weeks ago, I guess it was, I posted something where I was playing along with these chords because I've been doing this as kind of an exercise, a test of my endurance. And my practice guitar up at the house is the Mexican Strat with a big, huge neck, and I strung it up with 12 to 60 strings just so that I can get a good workout in with my fretting hand in a short amount of time. But I play the chords to this song as a test of my endurance and my precision with chording. And somebody mentioned I should do a free lesson about it, so that's what I'm going to do today. So the first thing you're going to see is a demonstration, and then I'm going to break down the different parts note by note. If you are a member of our TXBA Locals program, I will put together tablature so you can play along with the tablature for this. It'll be in the Pro Player along with all of our other free lessons and courses. And now let's take a look at the demonstration and get into the breakdown. Now this song is in standard tuning, or at least that's what I'm in when I'm playing this, and it's in the key of C. But we're not going anywhere near our normal box one shape. We're going to be playing it as a series of A form and E form chords here. And so we start with a C chord here, but instead of the normal way, we're going to play it as an A form starting here at the third fret. So you're going to fret the third fret of the A string, and then bar, either with your pinky or your ring finger, the fifth fret of the G, the D, G, and B string. And you can use a pick if you want to. If you want to work on your picking control. For this kind of rhythm, I prefer to use my fingertips. All we're doing is playing we're arpeggiating the notes of that chord. So we go up, we go down, and then we work our way up again. But before we hit the top, we drop a whole step. And play that same chord just down here at the first fret. And play the bottom three notes of it. So and then we play an F chord down here as an E form at the first fret. And I want you to arpeggiate the four bottom notes of that chord. Now, that's the progression you're going to play three times in a row. But to make it more challenging, I really want you to focus on each note ringing out solidly. No little flubs. On top of having all the notes ring out, focus on having the transition be seamless. In order to make this an effective drill, testing the endurance of your forearms and elbows and your fretting accuracy for these chords, you want it to be as if somebody programmed this into a MIDI and put it through a guitar synth or something. You want it to be precise. See, even there, see what happened there is I didn't move my finger down far enough and the bottom note of that chord didn't ring out. So when you practice this, what you want to work towards is every note ringing out clear. And the reason I picked this song is because when you are playing live, if you flub a note or something like that on a chord, it's not going to really show up. But if you do it when you're recording an album, then it's there for everybody to listen to for all of eternity. And so every once in a while, I like to have something where I work on perfection. There's so much of my playing where perfection is not needed or noticeable. But when it comes to playing this kind of a rhythm, every flaw stands out. All right, so we're gonna do that rhythm three times in a row. And right where we would normally jump back up, now we're gonna slide up here to a G minor seventh. Okay, that's where you're like playing a G minor as an E form chord. But then we drop off the D string back here to the fret that we're barring. That twice. Then we're going to jump up here, and I got to be honest, I don't know what the exact name of this chord is. I'm just sounding it out from the record. First fret of the A string, third fret of the D and G string, and then first fret of the B string. And here's where it gets tricky. On the second time through, you got to drop this third fret to the second fret. Ready to start. Okay, so that is kind of the first half of the progression. Three times through on this. Three times through on that. Then at the end of the third time, so that's the first half of the workout. Now, before we go into the second part, as we get to the end, you can kind of pause there because you're going to hear the lyrics. So won't you hear? And that's when you kind of start this downward sliding progression. You're going to slide up to the fifth fret of the A string here. Fret this little power chord here, fifth fret of the A string, seventh fret of the D and the G string. Play that one time, then slide down. Play it at the third fret there. And then we're going to do something tricky. You're going to keep your ring finger the same. Actually, you're going to switch from this. You're going to move your pinky down to the D string. Take your ring finger and fret the fourth fret of the G string and slide your index finger down here to the second fret of the A string. And then an open A power chord, open A, second fret of D and G. And then you can just go play. I think that's an augmented G chord there. And that's really the first break that your wrist and your forearm get. We're changing from this grip to this one. And so after you play that G chord, then you play that descending pattern again. Purposes of this lesson, that's where you can kind of consider the pattern done. But in the song, we go through this. Go right back into this. That is where the whole thing would start over again, because he's singing another verse. So there you have it. That is something that even if you're an advanced player, I am living proof that you can accomplish a lot in terms of, you know, speed and soloing and stuff that impresses people. But if I were in a situation where I got called to sit in, you know, let's say that I was more famous than I am, and I actually knew Doyle, and he got called me up to play on that song. Well, of course, I'd be playing rhythm. I would get through like a couple repetitions of that, and I'd have to kind of shake my arm out. And it's kind of a wake-up call to me that I work so much on all this soloing stuff, but then I go and I try and play this simple arpeggiated rhythm without any breaks or obviously flubbed notes, and I just fail miserably. So this is a mountain that I keep coming back to that I try to climb, simply because my goal is that if I ever am on that stage with somebody, whether it's playing this song or another one where I have that similar kind of rhythm, I don't want to have like all the soloing chops to hold my own, but then when it's my turn to play rhythm, I can barely get through it because I've underdeveloped chording and endurance. So anyway, those are the kind of things that I challenge myself with. Like I said, if you're a member of our locals program, I'm going to put tablature together for this whole pattern so you can practice it in our pro player. And if you aren't a member of the locals, you honestly should check it out. I'm going to put a link in the description to our testimonials page. Because there you're going to hear from players of all skill levels who have been members of the program and what they accomplished. It's a better advertisement than anything I could say. So hope you enjoy the lesson. I hope it challenges you, gives you something to do. Even if you're holding a guitar that's not plugged in, you can work on this. And until next time, thanks for watching.